I'm Jo Walton and this is Sarah, my daughter. Sarah was born in 1979 and she was a very wanted, healthy, happy baby. Went through all of her normal milestones, usually a little earlier than she should have done. And at the age of 11 months, she contracted measles. She won't particularly poorly and she recovered very rapidly and went on to have a very normal rest of her childhood. Her teenage years were marked by loads of successes. She did really well at GCSE level, she did really well at A level, and then she went off to university. And having finished with the 2-1, she decided that she would pop herself off to King's College to study midwifery. Around about the beginning of 2004, she told me that she wasn't feeling very well. And by the February of 2004, she was actually signed off her course. She was getting quite upset about the fact that she knew she was ill and she didn't know what it was that was wrong with her or what was going to happen. The progression of her illness went in stages. You'd think that she was okay and she was starting to recover a little bit. And then there would be something else would drop off. We eventually got a diagnosis at the beginning of September. The consultant came out to see us, so we knew that it wasn't good news. And at that point, we were told that she had subacute sclerosing panencephalitis and that this illness had been caused by the measles virus. The measles infection that she'd had when she was 11 months old, and it had taken over 24 years to actually develop into something far more deadly, far more devastating than the measles virus could ever be. SSPE is a very rare disorder. It's a very rare complication of the measles virus, but it is devastating. Right back at the beginning when Sarah was a baby, Sarah had had most of her normal vaccinations, but in terms of the measles vaccine, I'd more or less made the decision that we weren't going to go for it because of the allergy side of things, as it was an egg-based vaccine. But then nobody ever mentioned SSPE to me. That wasn't something that I was able to put into the mix in terms of the decisions that I was making. And I've got to say that now, knowing what SSPE can do and the devastation that it causes to a life that was full of so much promise and the devastation that it has wreaked on other lives that were so full of promise. If it was a choice between taking a risk against the possible allergy or allergic reactions to the vaccine, I think I'd go with those. In fact, I know I'd go with those rather than the risk of a child of mine contracting SSPE.